Hi. In this video, I'm going to be showing you how to make graphics using Java. It's quite easy, and we're using a package called HSA2 that takes Swing and makes it a lot simpler. First, we'll start with a Java project. And I'm calling it demonstrating HSA2. Unfortunately, I can't really type and speak at the same time, so there might be times where there's a bit of silence. So we have to go and get this HSA2 thing. We get it from GitHub. And from a user called Salamander2. Click on repositories, click on HSA2, and here it is. So what GitHub is this is a place where people store projects that they're working on and make modifications, and you can see there have been 81 modifications to this program since it was started. The folder that we actually need is HSA2. There's programs in here, sample programs. There's PDF files, which are documents. This is Java doc, and I don't think it's been updated. Here's a bit of information about HSA2. You can read it over. It puts a panel inside a JFrame. It hides all the event listeners. You don't have to learn all that stuff. All of the Swing commands are exactly the same. You can use images. You can use JOption panes for dialog boxes, but they're really simple. And there are some limitations, like you can't use JButtons, etc. But you don't really need to for most things. So we're going to download this and click here and download the whole thing. Boom. It has been downloaded. So we have to drag HSA2 into the source folder. It's not going to work because I have to extract this. It doesn't work as a zip file, so I have to extract all the files. Okay, this should work now. Take HSA2 and drag it into SRC. And you always want to copy it. I should have said copy. Looks like there's a problem which I haven't fixed. Ah, I forgot to import point. Okay, problem solved. Now I would like to show you some sample programs. We go up a level. Actually, right here are some sample programs. I'm not going to spend time typing these programs in because that's not the point of this video. The point of the video is to show you the things that can be done using HSA2. Again, we always copy the files. I guess I need to create a package called graphics1. Let's run this and see what happens. Boom, it makes graphics circles, colored circles. The first row has less brightness. The brightness is 60%. Second row is 100% brightness, 100% saturation. The bottom row has 100% brightness and less saturation. You can figure out how all this works if you want to. This is standard Java stuff. We're just setting the color, drawing an oval, and using a for loop to do 20 ovals in 3 rows. It's probably better to look at this program here. It's under first program. There is a detailed PDF file that explains what you have to do. And it looks like it's 5 pages. I'm not going to go through it all. I'm just going to copy the program. But you need to go through it all. Okay. All we have to import is HSA2 Graphics Console. If we look here, there's 5 files. The Graphics Console is the main one we're using, and this one calls Console Canvas. I never use these two, text input or text output, and I can't remember if I ever use fatal error for anything either. Don't ever edit these or fix them up or change them because they will mess up your program. They stay exactly how they are. If they get corrupted, download another copy from the internet. So this draws random colored circles on the screen. And there we are. The first program just had stationary circles, but here we have some sort of animation where circles are showing up randomly and fading away. The reason they're fading is because we have a semi-transparent color. If we just make the background black or dark gray, we just see that. And we're down here in a loop that loops forever. If we don't clear the screen each time through the loop, we'll get this. And these are the really bright colors. I think it's the middle row from the previous program. And it looks like there's a border around the edges, and it assumes that the window is 800 by 600, and using a ball size of 40 pixels, it does this stuff here. Yep, just draws an oval on the screen at the random X and Y, 40 by 40. So that looked pretty easy. I should probably make a graphics one package. Another example is this animation thing. If we look at the website, this is explaining how to do animation. And we're making a block-breaking game, which you can extend. And you can either use arrow keys or the mouse to control the paddle. There's 5 steps which you need to go through. So I guess we would click on step 1, and you'd read the instructions here. I'm not going to bother doing that. I'm going to go right to step 5. Oh, this is in a package called animation. And I'm just going to copy these 3 files into here. The PDF file really does explain how everything is working. So it starts really simple, and we can just add up stuff. Apparently you can press Q to quit. We have methods for moving the paddles. If you want to use the mouse, you go like that. And now you can use the mouse to move the paddle. Moves the ball, draws the graphics, etc., blah, blah, blah. So let's see it working. Okay, so this is a breakout game. And every time it hits the top, the ball speeds up. Oh, I have 1 life left. Oops. I died. Okay. So writing on the screen is fine. You don't really need J labels or J buttons for stuff like this. Okay, I think I will end this by showing you some programs that my students made in grade 11. So this one, create a game in which the user must survive in a maze for 15 seconds without hitting a moving ball or the yellow maze walls. Click to start, move using the mouse. Okay, that's really tiny there. Click to start. I move my mouse around, and the ball hit me, so the game's over. There's no restart button anywhere, so I'll have to restart the program this way. I think if I can go up here, I'll probably be safe. You can look at the code to find out what makes the ball move in such bizarre random ways, floating and bouncing and everything else like that. It's 17 seconds, so it actually doesn't tell you you win after 15 seconds. This one, okay, should have read this. Move the ball using the mouse. Catch the small yellow ball. Do not let the bigger balls hit you as they follow you. Okay. There's something weird here with this one. It seems to have frozen up sometimes. I can try and get it working if I do a click to start thing here. So before it does the main loop, it's going to wait for me to click the mouse. That might fix it. Nope. Even the cue doesn't work. I am not sure why this program is not working. Okay, let's just pretend that this is not happening. Could increase the sleep time. Oh, I know the problem. It hasn't enabled the mouse. When you're typing these commands, everything is basically using the graphics console, which we import up here, and we make a graphics console here, and calling it GC, and everything uses that. So when you type in GC point, it lists a whole pile of methods that you can use. What we want to do is use the ones that are specifically for the graphics console, not the other ones. Half the time, they're not going to work properly. So enable mouse, we can put that over there. It'll tell us what it does. And now, I click, good, I got the ball, I've got one score. Got to go up here. Oh, I made it a lot slower, so I'm actually able to win now, or do much better. Oop. Okay, I spoke too soon. Anyway, that is that game. The final game, already copied it, is called Ball Cross. Move the ball from the bottom to the top without getting hit by the white rectangles. I'm not very good at this, so I'm going to make the game a lot slower. Okay, and I have to use the cursor keys. Okay, good. I made it that far. Now, up to here. Oh, I won. Awesome. Okay, I'm really awesome. Actually, that was a really clever program. So these are programs that my grade 11 students made using graphics, using animation. Instructions for how to do this stuff should be online, especially the one that tells you how to do these blocks. There is one further thing to show people. And that is how we can use images. For now, I'm putting the images into the Java package. Nope, what is this thing here? This is the Java project. I'm putting them here because that is the default location for images and resources in Eclipse. It's possible to change that, but that is the subject of another video, which I have yet to make. What is that? I don't know what that is. Okay, so I made a side scroller using HSA2 graphics. Let's see how it works. Okay. This is my health. That's how much water I have. And there's people I can talk to. Oops. And I want to jump. I should be getting a gem. Got a gem. Great. I need to jump on the correct sequence of blocks. So these people are giving me hints. There are four stages. Don't drown until number four. So the water will be the fourth stage. Aha, that's stage one. Disappears. Stage one. Stage two. Stage three. Stage four. Whoops, crap, I died. Okay, I want to run this again. This time I fell through and I didn't get the stuff. One, two, three, four. Okay, so I've got all four stages. Now a door opens here. A chest opens and I go through this teleporting gem. I'm dying of thirst, drink carefully. So in this level, you're running out of water. And you don't want to drown. You just have to touch the water. Awesome. Okay. Climb up here. Oh, I think I need the key. Oh, and I somehow made the water disappear. Okay. Don't know where the ladybug is. Oh, here it comes. This is a tree which lets me fall through, so I'm not going to land on that. Oops. I didn't see what that clue was. Land on the chest, go down here, talk to the person, jump on the chest to trigger the gem. Grab the green gem to teleport again. Okay, this is pretty hard to get over there. Or maybe not. Yeah, I don't think this level got finished. I'm supposed to be flying in space somehow, but I don't know where I am. Oh, there I am. Anyway, whatever. Side-scrolling game, most of it is finished. Using graphics, HSA2, and somewhere we are loading images. I'll just show you how I load the images here. Probably in setup. Setup, load level. Load image. Oh, it loads the background image for the level. And it's using buffered image. Okay, so buffered images are working just fine in HSA2 graphics. Well, thank you for watching, and I hope this has been interesting, showing you the different things that can be done. And you can get students doing simple stuff very quickly and easily with things like this fading one. You can work through very easy to get this working. And then you can get more complicated animation programs as the semester goes on.